हेलो एवरीवन, सो टुडे वी आर हेयर टू डिस्कस अबाउट द इम्प्रेशन मटेरियल्स. लुक, योर डेंटल मटेरियल्स कैरीज 14 मार्क्स, इट्स फाइन, बट इम्प्रेशन मटेरियल्स इन द डेंटल मटेरियल्स कैरी अबाउट योर 30% ऑफ योर मार्क्स. मीन्स अराउंड फोर क्वेश्चंस यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट फ्रॉम द डेंटल मटेरियल्स, इधर फ्रॉम पॉलीसल्फाइड, कंडेंसेशन सिलिकॉन, एडिशन सिलिकॉन, इम्प्रेशन प्लास्टर, इम्प्रेशन कंपाउंड, ZOE, अगार, एल्जिनेट. सो इन कंप्लीट डेंटल मटेरियल्स आई फील दिस इज़ एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट. इट इज़ एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट बिकॉज देर आर सर्टन टॉपिक्स इन डेंटल मटेरियल्स दैट आर कवर्ड इन कंजर्वेटिव ऑल्सो. That includes your metallurgy, your composites, your dental cements, amalgam. So apart from that, what is left in dental materials, and amongst them the most important is impression materials. In an overlap, if you say there are certain topics that are common in dental materials and conservative, so I'll be considering them in the conservative only. In dental materials, it's basically your physical properties, gypsum, impression materials and ceramics. These are the four topics. Rest topics are overlapping with your conservative, and conservative includes your instrumentation and one more topic, that is other than the common part. Fine. So regarding the separate part, impression materials is a very important topic, holds a lots of number of questions, and making impression material question wrong will be a blunder, because you have seen every material, you know the properties of every material, you know the concepts of every material. So make sure you don't make its questions wrong. So myself, Dr. Richa, and let's start with the impression material. In this chapter of today, in the impression material, we'll be discussing about your classification of impression material, and means whether they are reversible, they are irreversible, they are elastic, they are inelastic, which falls in which category. Then we'll be dealing about your elastomeric impression materials. This is an important topic in it, and this includes your polysulfide, polyether, addition silicon and condensation silicon. So basically silicones that are of two types, and then impression making techniques, we'll be dealing with the monophase technique, multiple mix technique, putty wash technique, what are different techniques, in which viscosity the material is used, like in monophase, a single phase, a single viscosity is used, multiple mix, two mixes are made, fine. And then some of the properties of impression materials we'll be discussing, which of the following has got a highest shear strength, which of the following has got a highest working time, which is biocompatible, which is hydrophilic, which is hydrophobic, and some then disinfection part. Usually question is asked on disinfection, and new questions can also be made on disinfection. Then is your hydrocolloid impression material. That includes your agar and alginate. We'll be discussing with them separately. Agar and alginate, then your inelastic. So these were your elastics, like your polyether, polysulfide, addition silicon, condensation silicon, agar, alginate. Now we'll be discussing about inelastic, that would include your impression plaster, impression compound and zinc oxide eugenol. The composition of individually everyone is important. Basically questions are asked on composition mostly on this part, and then their function and all that. I'll be telling you two questions from each is usually asked. So first of all, let's come to the classification part, and in classification we'll come to see that the dental impression material are classified on the basis of chemical reaction, that is they are irreversible or reversible. So if there occurs a chemical reaction, you know in your 9th and 10th jab naya naya chemistry aaya tha, x plus y is equal to z, so whenever there is some chemical reaction, that material comes out to be irreversible, fine. And this would include your materials that are in this column, that is your plaster of Paris, zinc oxide eugenol, alginate, polysulfide, polyether, condensation silicon and addition silicon. And then there are going to be thermally induced, means by heat some of the setting mechanism is there. So whenever you change the temperature, the material reverses back to its original state. Fine. This includes your impression compound and agar. The impression compound you have seen while taking the impression. So it's basically thermally induced. Means if you'll heat it, it will become fluid. If you'll not heat it, if you'll keep it at a room temperature, and when the temperature of the water falls down, it comes back to its own original state, that it's become hard. So by the chemical reaction and by your thermally induced, it can be classified as reversible and irreversible. Next is your elastic and inelastic. Inelastic is something that can be stretched, fine, and it includes your alginate, polysulfide, polyether, condensation silicone, these and your addition silicone, yeah, these four. तो ये याद ही रखना, इलास्टिक में आते हैं. एंड एगार एंड एल्जिनेट आर हाइड्रोकोलोइड्स, बट दे आर ऑल्सो इलास्टिक इन नेचर, फाइन. एंड नेक्स्ट इज योर इनइलास्टिक, दैट इंक्लूड्स योर प्लास्टर ऑफ पेरिस एंड जिंक ऑक्साइड यूजेनॉल. सो द क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज इलास्टिक, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज इनइलास्टिक. एंड इनइलास्टिक दे कैन गिव यू ऑप्शंस लाइक इंप्रेशन कंपाउंड, अगार, एल्जिनेट, पॉलीसल्फाइड. यू विल नो दैट इट इज inelastic. Which of the following sets by a chemical reaction they can give you? Alginate, impression compound, agar. In options, the answer will be your alginate. So these type of mix and match questions can be asked, that this is irreversible, this is reversible, this is inelastic, and this is elastic. So if you know the concept, you will be able to solve all the questions that, yeah, this falls in this category. Another type of question that can be asked is, which of the following is inelastic and sets by a chemical reaction? So the answer for that will be your, you'll have to look for zinc oxide eugenol or plaster of Paris. Fine. These are inelastic, these are going to set by a chemical reaction. Which of the following is elastic and is also thermally induced? The answer will be agar. So basic sense in your mind, you have seen every material, so hopefully all the questions will be solved by this table. Next, let us come to the polysulfide part. You can see that this is a polysulfide, fine, and here this PbO2, that is your lead oxide, is going to give it a characteristic color. So the question can be very easily asked that which of the following is going to provide it a brown color to the polysulfide. Answer will be your lead oxide. Another question that can be asked is that which of the following act as a filler, and it is your titanium oxide, fine. This is acting as a filler. Next is plasticizer is dibutyl phthalate. Many materials you will see this is a plasticizer, so nothing to remember. Sulfur acts as an accelerator, nothing to remember. And lead oxide act as a catalyst, this is something to be remembered here. Lead oxide act as a catalyst in polysulfide and it provides it a characteristic brown color. This question can be asked. And what is the byproduct? You can see that PbO2, PbO plus O, and two molecules of the hydrogen, so they are making H2O. So water is a byproduct. That's it. Here comes end to the polysulfide. These are the questions that are asked. Which of the following act as a catalyst? What is the byproduct which gives its brown color? Which of the following act as a filler? Fine. So here it is what the polysulfide is all about. Next we'll come to your condensation silicone. Here you can see, let me zoom it a little bit, that in condensation silicone the byproduct is C2H5OH, C2H5OH. So stannous octoate act as a catalyst. You have to remember this thing, SNO2. Stannous octoate act as a catalyst, and byproduct is your ethyl alcohol. Fine. And nothing much about it. And the liquid is a catalyst, and stannous octoate act as a catalyst, and the byproduct is ethyl alcohol. That's it. Nothing much about it. And next we come to your addition silicone. Addition silicone, you have to remember that it is also known as polyvinyl siloxane. The question is asked, which of the following is known as polyvinyl siloxane, and here the platinum is going to act as a catalyst. So there's tannous oxide, there lead oxide, here is platinum. Platinum is going to act as a catalyst, but in case of addition silicon, there are no byproduct. No byproduct. There was in condensation silicon ethyl alcohol in polysulfide, there was water, but in case of addition silicon, no byproducts are there in it. And polymethyl hydroxysilane can lead to secondary reaction with each other or with the moisture to produce hydrogen gas. So the question can be asked, which material produces hydrogen gas? Answer is your addition silicon. This is very important because this leads to the pinpoint voids on the cast. You will see there are point voids on the cast because the material is producing the hydrogen gas that is producing voids on the cast. So usually the manufacturer add a noble metal like palladium, which acts as a scavenger for the release of hydrogen gas. Like means whenever there is some release of hydrogen gas, palladium will eat that. So there is no pinpoint voids on the cast. Fine. And another, it is hydrophobic in nature. Everyone is hydrophobic except polyether, that is hydrophilic. But question is asked on addition silicon that it is hydrophobic in nature. So these are all the points that you should be knowing about the addition silicon. And this is the reaction you can see. And platinum salt here acts as a catalyst. You can see here. Can you appreciate this is a platinum salt? Here it acts as a catalyst and no byproduct is formed. Usually the questions are much like this only on this. Fine. Next we'll move to your polyether. Regarding polyether, not much should be knowing that you should be knowing that what is the base paste, and there is a polyether polymer. And in the base paste there is polyether polymer, there is colloidal silica that acts as a filler. So yeah, silica wagera, whenever you get a name now, you should be knowing that it acts as a filler. Phthalate and all, whenever you get na, you should be knowing it acts as a plasticizer. Okay, here the plasticizer is glycol ether or phthalate or PTHALAT. So nothing to waste much time on it. So these are the components of your base paste. And in accelerator paste, there is again a filler, there is again a plasticizer, there is again alkyl aromatic sulfate. So the, not much questions on it, but yeah, the question is that it is usually hydrophilic in nature. Fine. This question is usually asked. And one question on biocompatibility of polyether we'll be discussing in the next slides. So these were the basic things about addition silicon, condensation silicon and polysulfide and polyether, which are usually asked. Baki their properties, tear strength, dimension stability, rheological properties, questions are asked, we'll be discussing later. And a very nice table is given in the dental pulse, which is comparing every single material. I'll be discussing that also with you in a separate video, where I'll be discussing all the tables of dental material. Next comes your impression making, and in impression making comes your multiple mix technique, your monophase technique and your putty wash technique. So in multiple mix technique, you should be knowing that there is a multiple mix, as the name suggests. There are two types of mix are there. One is a light body, that is a syringe material. Next is a heavy body, that is a tray material. So what happens in multiple mix? We just put the syringe material over the tooth, like syringe material is like this, put over the tooth, and over it we are going to put your tray filled with the material. So this is your multiple mix technique. And the question that is usually asked is which is placed first. Syringe material is placed first, then the tray material, and it includes two types, light body and heavy body. Fine. This is what is usually asked in multiple mix technique. Next is your monophase technique. Monophase technique is also known as single viscosity technique, since only one mixture is made. Fine. Only one viscosity is used. Part of it you are going to place in a tray and part of it you are going to place on a syringe. Fine. And the syringe material you are going to put on the tooth. So same viscosity material is put in two parts and used like this. Yeah, first you will like a multiple mix. First you will put the syringe material on it, then you will put that on that. What happens is that while you will put the syringe material, you will put it in a bit lighter viscosity and tray wala thodi der ruk ke, when it gains some medium consistency, then you will put it. But the material that is made is one and that of the same consistency. Not much questions on it, don't worry. Next is your putty wash technique. In putty on a steak stock tray and an impression is made. So first you are going, what you are going to do is you are going to take an impression by the material whose consistency is putty, and then you are going to trim a little bit of the material with your BP blade or whatever, and you are going to make some space for a wash material. Fine. And then wash material is put on the putty impression and an impression is made. So basically putty wash technique, one putty, and another is wash material, two things are there and impression is made. So monophase technique, multiple mix technique, putty wash technique, their name itself suggests what material is used, what is the procedure that is used, and the questions are simple and straightforward in this topic. Next is your properties of elastomeric impression. So in properties of elastomeric impression, we'll be discussing about your working time and setting time. So in this part, what is working time you should be knowing, what is setting time you should be knowing, because the questions are asked, what is working time, what is setting time. Matlab this is not something related to some impression material, but the question is asked. So the working time is the one that begins at the start of the mixing and ends just before the elastic properties are developed. You will find such questions so you'll start mixing and just before it starts becoming elastic, that is your working time. Means you are able to spread it, means it is flowy completely. That time is your working time. And setting time is the time that has elapsed from the beginning of the mixing until the curing process has advanced sufficiently that the impression can be removed from the mouth with no distortion. So from the starting of the mixing, both are going to start, but till the elastic properties are developed, it's working time. And till the time you can snap it out from the mouth, means you have done everything, you have spread it, it has set down, it has polymerized completely and all that, and till the time you are able to remove it from there, that is known as your setting time. Not much question on rheological properties, its flow, pseudoplastic, thixotropic, but not much question. Next is your elasticity and viscoelasticity, that this material is elastic and all. But the question that can be asked is on your tear strength. And regarding elasticity is basically about stiffness. Fine. So which material is more stiff? The order is like this. If I tell you regarding stiffness, it's like polysulfide, then condensation silicon, and then your adhesion silicon, and then your polyether. So polyether is the most stiff material, and the question that can be asked is which one of the following has got least stiffness? It's polysulfide. Which one of the following has got most stiffness? It's your polyether. And because of which it cannot be used in undercut areas, because it is very stiff. If you are going to remove it, either you are going to damage the prosthesis nearby or something else. It cannot also be used in undercut areas much. So, and even it is sometimes said that polyether cannot be used whenever the teeth are mobile, because because it is very stiff, and when you are going to snap it out, when you are going to remove the impression, it can lead to even the tooth will also come out. So that's why the question that can be asked is your most stiff is polyether, least stiff is your polysulfide. That's it. Next is your tear strength, and in tear strength you should be knowing what is tear strength. A tear strength basically measure the resistance of an elastic material to the fracture when subjected to a tensile force perpendicular to the surface force. So जब तक वो material टूट नहीं जाएगा, फट नहीं जाएगा, that is your tear strength. And the question that is asked is regarding tear strength is that your silicones, then polyether and then polysulfide. Which of the following has got the highest tear strength is your polysulfide. The question is not much asked on silicon and polyether, less or what, like, but which one of the following is most stiff is your polyether. Which of the following has got highest tear strength is your polysulfide. Fine. So a quick snap in removing the impression usually increases the tear strength. That's why we say just move it with a quick snap. The question is asked, how would you prefer the removal of the impression? So the options are like this: you will shake, you will make it left and right, you will go slowly, or you will remove it with a quick snap. You are going to remove it with a quick snap because quick snap increases the tear strength of that material, and because the tear strength is increased, the material does not break easily. So this is a question, new questions usually asked. This question, and polysulfide has got a resistance to tearing, so it has got a good tear strength. The question is asked this way. And next is your dimensional stability. The question usually asked is the most stable is your adhesion silicone. I have told you there are no byproducts, and since there are no byproducts, so jitna gaya utna nikla. So the dimensionally stable impression material is your adhesion silicone, and then comes after that your polyether, polysulfide, and the least one is your condensation silicone. Fine. So the most dimensionally unstable is condensation silicone, and dimensionally stable is adhesion silicone. Fine. Shelf life, not much question that have been asked or I have come across, so not much on it. A question I remember came about 2 to 3 years back on shelf life in AIIMS, but yeah, I'll tell you if I'll get through it. So these are the elastic properties. Most stiff polyether, this one, and most highest tear strength polysulfide, this one, and most dimensionally stable is your adhesion silicone. So these are the question, and what is the working time, what is the setting time, and some miniature questions like least stiff is polysulfide, or if you know the sequence they can tell you, arrange it in an increasing order or a decreasing order, like that. So that's it. This is what is usually asked from this topic. Next is a disinfection part, and regarding disinfection, you would come across the question of alginate, glutaraldehyde, that's it. But let me discuss regarding everyone, since we have started with the elastomeric impression. So first of all comes, the area to be discussed is your polysulfide or silicone. Method is immersion, and into the glutaraldehyde or chlorine compounds, like that. And disinfectant requiring more than 30 minutes are not recommended. So usually you can say glutaraldehyde is used. Fine. And in polyether, chlorine compounds are used. Fine. And in ZOA, glutaraldehyde or iodophores are used, and in impression compound, iodophores are used. So glutaraldehyde for ZOA, and glutaraldehyde again for polysulfide and silicone. Fine. And in case of alginate, again chlorine compounds or iodophores are used, and even for less than 10 minutes. So question is usually asked on alginate. Short-term glutaraldehyde has shown to be acceptable, but glutaraldehyde is not for alginate. So you can just see that in the options, the answer will be chlorine compounds, iodophores, glutaraldehyde. So this is used. Fine. And simple and straightforward questions, and usually by immersion only. You are going to immerse the material impression into that disinfectant. Fine. Next we come to your alginate, and we come to your agar part. And one more point here, I think so have been left, is your biocompatibility. you just make it a note. And biocompatibility, polysulfide has got lowest cell death count. So polysulfide comes out with your highest cell adaptability, highest tear strength is polysulfide, highest adaptability is your polysulfide, and polyether comes with the highest cell toxicity, that when you are going to use polyether, it is going to cause allergy, it is going to cause some dermatitis or something like that, it is going to harm the skin, that is your polyether. Fine. And now we'll start with the hydrocolloids, and here comes your two hydrocolloids, alginate and agar. The question can be asked, which of the following amongst the following is an hydrocolloid? Either amongst the four you will be able to see alginate or agar, and the answer will be that. Easy question, first year dental material, you know these two are hydrocolloids, nothing much to be known. And another question can be asked, that if these are called hydrocolloids, but they are arranged in the form of micelles. So micelles is something like meshed up like this. So these are in, which of the following is a characteristic feature of hydrocolloid? It's micelles. Okay. Next we come to agar. Clear? And image based question can come from this. That what is it used for? It is used for agar. What is it called as? It is called as conditioning unit, that is used for agar impression material. And that's it. Fine. And agar mein composition aapko pata honi chahiye, kya hoti hai impression, kaise lete hain, sole kya hota hai, gel kya hota hai, liquefaction temperature kya hota hai, gelation temperature kya hota hai. These are the areas around which the examiner asks question. Fine. So basically you should be knowing what all this is. So I'll tell you everything, don't worry. Basically from the gel is going to liquefy to a sole. Gel, you know the consistency of the gel is gel. So something that is liquid is your sole, and something that is a little bit solidified is your gel. And gel is going to convert into the sole by liquefying the temperature. Means let me tell you that gel is going to convert into sole by increasing the temperature, and that temperature is known as liquefaction temperature. Something that is of the gel consistency, obviously that is going to convert into liquid by increasing the temperature, and that temperature is known as liquefaction temperature. And gel to and sole to the gel means something that is going to, that is very liquid and it's going to become gel. Now gel is being made, that is known as your gelation temperature. So very thoda sa confusing hai, or I have made it confusing, I don't know, but you should be knowing that sole to gel is by gelation temperature, and gel to sole is by liquefaction temperature. Fine. And gel to sole is by increasing the temperature, that is liquefaction temperature is increasing, and from sole to gel is by gelation temperature, that is by decreasing the temperature. So what are these temperatures, you should be knowing. Let me clear them to you a little bit. Yeah, liquefaction temperature is 100 degrees Celsius, and your storage temperature is 65 degrees Celsius, and tempering temperature is 45 degrees Celsius. These are liquefaction, storage and tempering. So in this table you can see there are three units. So one is for liquefaction and the temperature is 100 degrees Celsius, and next is your storage, matlab usko liquefy karke aapne usko thodi der rakha hai, that is your in a sole stage, that is your 65 degrees Celsius temperature, and then tempering at 45 degrees Celsius temperature, you should be knowing. And another point you should be knowing is what is gelation temperature and what is liquefaction temperature. Liquefaction I have told you 100 degrees Celsius, and gelation is normally इक्वल टू द ह्यूमन बॉडी टेम्परेचर 37 डिग्री सेल्सियस इतना रहता है. एंड मेकिंग ऑफ द अगार इम्प्रेशन इन्वॉल्व्स योर दीज थ्री थिंग्स, दीज थ्री यूनिट्स. वन इज लिक्विफाइंग, स्टोरेज एंड टेम्परिंग यूनिट. एंड दीज थ्री थिंग्स आर नीडेड फॉर द मेकिंग ऑफ द इम्प्रेशन. एंड That's it, and its composition should be known. Let me see, have I put the composition in the slide? No. So it includes, composition includes basically your agar, your borates, your sulfates, your wax, thixotropic material, and water, which act as a reaction material. So the question can be asked, which of the following is used as a strengthener in agar? It's your borax. And agar, the question can be asked, is obtained from a seaweed. So this question is also asked. Composition I have made clear to you, that the composition mein borax pe aata hai, it acts as a strengthener. And making of an impression, I have told you, it has got three impression making units. One is your liquefaction, then is your storage, and then is your tempering. And the first step is to liquefy the hydrocolloid gel in the tube in a boiling water for 100 degree Celsius for a minimum of 10 minutes. That is the work of this unit. 100 degree pe rakhenge, 10 minute ke liye rakhenge, aur us gel ko sol banayenge. Fine. And then is passed to a storage bath at 65 degree Celsius to retain the sol condition until it is needed. तो सेकेंड में हम इसको स्टोरेज में रखेंगे, 65 डिग्री सेल्सियस में रखेंगे, और जब तक नहीं चाहिए वो सोल में, सोल कंडीशन में पड़ा रहेगा. एंड फॉर द इमीडिएट प्रिपरेशन स्टेप, द इम्प्रेशन मटेरियल ट्रे इज फिल्ड विद द हाइड्रोकोलोइड सोल फ्रॉम द ट्यूब टेकन फ्रॉम द, अगर एकदम से चाहिए तो इसी में से ही लेकर के विल पुट द अगार एंड विल टेक द इम्प्रेशन. एंड ट्रे इज प्लेस्ड इन अ वाटर फिल्ड टेम्परिंग कंपार्टमेंट. ट्रे में हमने इम्प्रेशन लिया और उसको इसमें डाल दिया टेम्परिंग में. टेम्परिंग टेम्परेचर इज़ योर 45 डिग्री सेल्सियस टेम्परेचर. द टेम्परिंग टाइम इज 3 to 10 मिनट्स, जस्ट सफिशियंट टू इंश्योर दैट ऑल द मटेरियल हैज़ रीच्ड अ लोअर टेम्परेचर. मतलब 100 से 55 से कम टेम्परेचर पहुँच गया है. इन एनी केस द लोडेड ट्रे शुड नेवर बी लेफ्ट इन द बाथ फॉर मोर देन 10 मिनट्स. तो यहाँ पर 10 मिनट से ऊपर नहीं रखना है. एज पार्शियल जेलेशन कैन स्टार्ट टू अक्कर. सो हमने इसको यहाँ पर सोल कंडीशन में रखा था, फिर यहाँ पर हमने इसको स्टोरेज किया, फिर हमने इसको टेम्परिंग सोल्यूशन में रखा थोड़ी देर के लिए, एंड देन विल टेक एन इम्प्रेशन. सो सोल जेल इज़ क्लियर, लिक्विफेक्शन टेम्परेचर इज़ क्लियर, जेलेशन टेम्परेचर इज़ क्लियर. फाइन, लिक्विफेक्शन टेम्परेचर आपको याद रखना है कि इट इज़ 100 डिग्री सेल्सियस. जेलेशन टेम्परेचर इज़ योर 37 डिग्री सेल्सियस. तो जेलेशन इज़ यूजली एक्सेलरेटेड बाय सर्कुलेटिंग द कोल्ड वाटर ऑन इट 18 से 21 डिग्री सेल्सियस थ्रू आउट द ट्रे फॉर 3 to 5 मिनट्स. एंड ड्यूरिंग द जेलेशन प्रोसेस द ट्रे मस्ट बी हेल्ड इन द माउथ अंटिल द जेलेशन हैज़ प्रोसीडेड टू अ पॉइंट एट विच द जेल स्ट्रेंथ इज सफिशियंट इनफ टू रेजिस्ट द डिफॉर्मेशन और फ्रैक्चर. अब हमने इम्प्रेशन ले लिया, उसके बाद क्या करेंगे? It is very important that these agar is going to exhibit the hydroelastic your viscoelastic behavior. So we are going to remove the agar impression with a snap. Question is usually asked. So you are going to झटके से आप agar impression को निकालेंगे without any twisting or flexure, and this is the way this needs to be removed with a snap. This question is usually asked. So here we come to the end of the agar. Your composition should be clear. Impression कैसे ले रहे हैं? Conditioning unit should be clear. Sol gel should be clear. Liquefaction temperature should be clear. Gelation temperature should be clear. And to remove it with a snap. That's it. And it is obtained from the seaweed. Next we come to the alginate. Again, in case of alginate, a lot of questions from this topic of alginate. And so let me start with alginate. Yeah, So you know about alginate, it's by chemical reaction, it is elastic in nature, it is hydrocolloid. So what happens in alginate, this reaction is very important, that the potassium alginate is going to react with calcium sulfate, and here calcium is going to react with alginate to form the calcium alginate and potassium sulfate. Fine. So the end product of the alginate reaction is calcium alginate. The question asked endless number of times, which one of the following acts as an end product? Another question that can be asked, which of the following act as a retarder? Retarder is your sodium phosphate. Sodium phosphate is a retarder, and how it acts as a retarder? Because it prevents the formation of the calcium alginate, and it will keep on forming, it will keep on keeping the calcium busy, ki come and make phosphate with me. So when the calcium is not free, calcium alginate will not be formed. So as a result, bahut der baad calcium alginate banega. It will act as a retarder, it will prolong the setting time, and in between you can mix it, you can do the tissue management, you can put the alginate impression. You need 2 to 3 minutes to do all that, and that is because of the retarder. So next is your composition. Here comes, it's your potassium alginate. You can see here it is. It is there, calcium sulfate, here it is, you can see. Potassium alginate, calcium alginate, appreciate it. And then zinc oxide, which acts as a filler. Question can be asked, which of the following acts as a filler? Answer is your zinc oxide. And potassium titanium fluoride and diatomous earth, which of the following acts as a filler particle? Question can be asked, it's diatomous earth. And sodium phosphate acts as a retarder. So these are the questions that are usually asked. What is the end product? Which of the following act as a retarder? Which of the following act as a filler product? That is your diatomous earth. And how the reaction proceeds, how you're going to control the reaction. So the composition part is pretty well clear to you, reaction is clear to you. And another important question from alginate is that whenever you are going to open that alginate pack, obviously, so some of the alginate is fluffed to break loose the particles, and the diatomous earth, which is made up of the fine porous silica particles, will become airborne, and the lid is removed. And so basically whenever you open, so sometimes diatomous earth part filler article, which acts as a filler, it comes out and you are going to inhale that. And even when you are going to put alginate into the rubber bowl, then also you are going to see that alginate ke thoda thoda dhoora sa udta hai. So what it is going to do, it is going to expose to your lungs, and it can cause silicosis, it can cause pulmonary hypersensitivity. Even I have seen some of the lab technicians who are working for 30 years in the dental department, they open the alginate, they mix it daily, they have got silicosis. So because of this airborne particles or this diatomous earth is fluffed out, to remove it, there is a production, there is an encounter of your dustless alginate, and which has incorporated the polyethylene glycol or polypropylene glycol on the alginate powder. So what happens is that polyethylene glycol, ये एल्जिनेट का पाउडर है, इसको कवर करेगा तो ये बाहर इतना नहीं उड़ेगा, एंड इट विल नॉट कॉज सिलिकोसिस और पल्मोनरी हाइपरटेंशन. माइंड इट, क्वेश्चन इज आस्क्ड, व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज अ डस्टलेस एल्जिनेट, हाउ कैन यू मेक डस्टलेस एल्जिनेट, फ्रॉम विच द एल्जिनेट इज कोटेड टू मेक इट डस्टलेस एल्जिनेट, इट इज your polypropylene glycol. And what is the side effect of the dusting alginate? It is your silicosis and pulmonary hypertension. So that is usually asked. Next is about your, the question can be asked, your setting time can be controlled by adding the retarder. And another important point regarding alginate is, you have seen even in your clinics also that what happens in summers, the alginate is going to set very fast. So the normal requirement is your normal water, गर्मी में इसका रिएक्शन फास्ट होता है, ये फास्ट सेटिंग हो जाता है, तो यू हैव टू टेक गर्मी में ठंडा पानी फॉर इट. नो, टैप वाटर इज़ नॉट गोइंग टू वर्क फॉर इट. एंड अनदर पॉइंट यू शुड बी नोइंग इज दैट इट शुड नेवर बी मिक्स्ड इन बाउल दैट इन विच यू हैव अर्लियर मिक्स्ड प्लास्टर और स्टोन, बिकॉज सम कैल्शियम पार्टिकल्स आर देयर एंड इफ यू आर गोइंग टू मिक्स इट इन दैम, दैट कैल्शियम इज गोइंग टू रिएक्ट विद एल्जिनेट पार्ट, पोटेशियम एल्जिनेट पार्ट, एंड कैल्शियम एल्जिनेट विल बी फॉर्म्ड फास्ट. Fine, because this is the product and more calcium sulfate will be there because you are mixing it in some bowl where you have mixed impression plaster or stone earlier. So more calcium will be available and more calcium alginate will be formed. The faster will be the reaction. So it should not be mixed in that. And another question that is usually asked is you have to mix alginate in your rubber bowl with the plastic spatula. And what you are going to do is, first you are going to put water and then you are going to put powder, because when you will put the powder and then water will not get incorporated completely into the powder. So pehle pani and then powder and then figure of eight motion. The question is asked how alginate is mixed, figure of eight motion. And another, you are going to mix it for 45 to 1 minute and the equipment should be clean, not gypsum leftovers in it. And another question that is asked on alginate is your fast setting, and fast setting is going to take your 1.5 to 3 minutes. Fine. And slow setting alginate is going to take 3 to 4.5 minutes. So this is an important point. What is fast setting alginate? What is slow setting alginate? Another question on alginate that is asked is your ratio, maybe 15 gram of the powder in the 40 ml of the water. That is asked. That's it. This is what the whole about alginate is. These are the questions that are asked. Once you have done this, you will be able to answer every question of the alginate. Fine. Next we come to your laminate technique and agar alginate technique. These two techniques should be known, and let me start you with it. Laminate technique is basically the technique in which both agar is used, and laminate technique itself is called as an agar alginate technique. There is no difference, right? Where agar and alginate both are used, right? And what you are going to do is agar will be used as a syringe material, and agar will be placed over the tooth, and alginate will act as a tray material. Fine. Alginate will act as a tray material. So alginate is going to react by its own chemical reaction that is forming your calcium alginate, so whatever the reaction is, but agar is going to convert into the gel state by the coolness of your alginate. So you're going to separate this, put the syringe material on the tooth, that is agar, and you are going to place a tray over it that is loaded with the alginate. So agar is going to set down because of the coolness of the alginate, and alginate is going to set down because of its own chemical reaction. And because agar and alginate are used, this is known as agar alginate technique or laminate technique. Clear? This is a question and this is usually asked, that what is laminate technique, which of the following is used as a tray material, which of the following is used as a syringe material, and why is it called as agar alginate technique. So pretty much clear with this thing. Regarding here I am seeing a table regarding your disinfection part. Now we have done with the agar and alginate. Let me come here, and in case of alginate, iodophores are used, and in case of agar also chlorine compounds or iodophores are used, or a household bleach is used. Fine, these three things are used as a disinfectant. in both Agar and Alginate. Yeah, another point I want you to be knowing is regarding your one more important thing that you should be knowing is two terms, imbibition and synaresis. These things should be known. Whenever the hydrocolloid impression material is removed from the mouth and it is exposed to ear, टू एयर, लाइक जब आप एल्जिनेट भी निकालते हैं दैट इज़ एक्सपोज टू एयर, फाइन, दैट कॉजेज इट्स श्रिंकेज एंड दैट फिनोमिना इज नोन एज योर सिनेरेसिस. सो दिस थिंग शुड बी नोइंग दैट फिनोमिना इज नोन एज सिनेरेसिस और इवेपोरेशन. सो द क्वेश्चन इज आस्ड विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग फिनोमिना इज सिनेरेसिस. The material is losing some water. That phenomena is known as synaresis. Synaresis is shown by hydrocolloids. This thing should be clear. These are not the synaresis phenomena is not shown by your elastic mein jo aata polysulfide, polyether addition, silicon condensation, silicon. So question can be asked. Synaresis is a property of hydrocolloids. And then is your imbibition. What happens in imbibition? That whenever you are going to immerse the impression in the water, there is going to occur some swelling. Fine. And that swelling is caused by imbibition of water. And these two things are performed by your hydrocolloids. So these two things should be known to you. Okay? And since the hydrocolloids show synaresis, that's why they cannot be put into the air like this ki aapne alginate ka impression liya aur rakh diya. They are needed to be put in a humidifier or in a 100% relative humidity so that no dimensional change occur. Fine. So question usually asked on agar that it needs to be put in some humidifier, alginate also in humidifier, or alginate needs to be put as soon as possible, otherwise synaresis will occur, shrinkage will occur. But the question for the humidifier on alginate, for the synaresis, question on the humidifier for agar, and question on synaresis for generally hydrocolloids, imbibition hydrocolloids, and what happens when, what is it called when it imbibes the water? Imbibition. When it loses the water, it's synaresis. Fine. And next we come to your inelastic impression materials, and inelastic impression materials includes impression plaster, impression compound and ZOE. Fine. So let's start with that also. Regarding impression plaster, not much to be known except its composition. And you are very clear with impression plaster already that you have used it while taking the impression of edentulous patient and all. So impressions compound can be of two types, that is your type 1 and type 2, and it is available in the form of cones or sticks like that. And its fusion temperature 39 degree Celsius you should be knowing. Its composition you should be knowing for the impression compound. Easily you can see here and there for impression compound, not much on it. Includes waxes, resin and filler or a coloring agent. All these things should be known to you. And what is fusion temperature? That is the temperature above which it starts to become plastic. Fine. And there are two types of impression compound. Type 1 is lower fusing, that is used for taking impression in the oral cavity, and type 2 is used as a tray compound, means you can directly even use that type 2 as a tray. Above it you can use some ZOE and all and take a secondary impression. So these are the questions from the impression compound. And from the zinc oxide eugenol, the question that is usually asked is what is the percentage of zinc oxide in ZOE? It's 87%. And what is the concentration of zinc oxide in zinc phosphate cement? It's 90%. And what is the concentration of zinc oxide in your gutta percha? It's 66%. So confusing, but yeah, the questions are asked. And which of the following, what is the ये यूजिनॉल इज 12% एंड सिलिका इज 20% एंड विच ऑफ द वट इज लेनोलिन इट्स एक्ट एज अ रिटार्डर, ऐसे क्वेश्चन आ सकता है. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग एक्ट एज अ रिटार्डर इन जिंक ऑक्साइड यूजिनॉल एंड सिलिका एक्ट्स एज अ फिलर, दिस क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड. एंड कैल्शियम क्लोराइड एक्ट्स एज एन एसिलरेटर इन योर जिंक ऑक्साइड यूजिनॉल, दिस कैन बी आस्क्ड. एंड सो द कंपोजिशन शुड बी क्लियर टू यू. क्वेश्चंस यूजुअली कम फ्रॉम द कंपोजिशन पार्ट ऑफ जिंक ऑक्साइड यूजिनॉल. एंड अनदर क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड दैट इट इज गोइंग टू सेट बाय अ केमिकल रिएक्शन, इट फॉर्म्स द चिलेट्स. सो विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग sets by your chemical reaction, which of the following forms the chelates? It's zinc oxide, eugenol. And so zinc oxide will react with water to form zinc hydroxide. So it forms the chelates in the form of zinc eugenolate. This question can be asked. Fine. And no shrinkage on it. Very fine details it provides. It's used for secondary impressions and there are two types of pastes in zinc oxide eugenol, type 1 paste or type 2 paste, and it is differentiated type 1 and type 2 on the basis of the setting time. And for the type 1 paste, setting time is 15 minute, and type 2 paste is your soft type, and its setting time is different. That is a question that can be asked. That's it. These are the questions from, let me see, one or two another questions if I can get for ZO, if my side for you. And that's it. These are the questions usually asked. Just wait for a second. Very beautifully given about ZOE, and don't go for Phillips for this zinc oxide and plaster of Paris and all that. You can follow Manapali for it. So that's it. These are the major questions that I quickly asked. If I'll get one or two, I'll give you in the group the questions if I'll get, but these are the ones that are asked. So everything is created twice, first in the mind and then in the reality. This is the line I love the most. So from the day one, just start your preparation and start creating the things in the mind that, yeah, I am going to enter a GDC. Yeah, this is going to be my graduation life, post-graduation life. Yeah, these are the brands I am going to wear. Yeah, these are the places I am going to visit. And yeah, this is the thing I am going to do with the amount of money I'll get as a stipend that will act as my own money. So you have to create the things in your mind. This is the department I am going to get. This is the college. You know, when I used to study, so I used to dream like this. So you should also dream in your mind, and you should create your future in your mind. Yeah, I am going to get into Maulana Azad. Yeah, I am going to get across the department. Yeah, I am going to do this. I am going to do that. I'll be making the dentures. I am going to be a good doctor. So just create the things in your mind, and surely the things will be created in the reality for sure. And for more demo part, you can contact me. My contact number is your 7065800060. Yeah. So demo part, you can contact me. And